And we begin with breaking news. In a stunning backflip, Prince Andrew has settled his sex abuse lawsuit with Virginia Giuffre, sparing him a humiliating court battle. Europe correspondent Brett McLeod is outside Buckingham Palace this morning. Brett, do we know how much the prince will be paying?
No sum has been disclosed, Ali, but it will be in the millions of dollars. Not only a settlement to Ms. Giuffre, but also he's agreed to make a donation to her charity. There's no admission of guilt by the prince against her allegations that he sexually assaulted her when she was a teenager. But in the statement, he says that Prince Andrew regrets his association with Jeffrey Epstein and commends the bravery of Miss Giuffre. Gloria Allred is a lawyer who represented many of the victims of Jeffrey Epstein. This was her response.
He admits, Prince Andrew, that Virginia was a victim of abuse. But what does he not say? He doesn't say by whom, he doesn't say when, and he doesn't say it was sexual abuse, and he certainly doesn't say that he is the one who victimized her.
As to whether Prince Andrew can ever return to public life, not considered very likely, although he may be now permitted to attend his father's memorial service next month. Ali?
Thanks, Brett.
Back home, COVID restrictions could be a thing of the past in our eastern states as booster mandates are enforced across the country. We have reporters right across the country as well this morning. Today's Isabella Stashkovsky is in Melbourne southeast. Isa, how are parents reacting to the new rules?
Carl, good morning. Well, people we've spoken to here this morning are pretty divided, and I have to say there has been uproar on social media, some calling this new rule revolting, while others are saying they really feel for school staff who will have to manage this. Essentially, here in Victoria, from March 15, parents, carers, visitors and volunteers will need to have 3 jabs in order to go to a school building or any kind of school event. So that does mean that hundreds of thousands of Victorians this morning are facing the reality of either getting a booster or essentially being locked out of their own children's school. Here's some people we spoke to a little earlier.
Look, with what we've been through with the pandemic, I feel it's probably, if it's keeping our kids safe, then I'm fine with it.
I'm ultimately for freedom of choice, and I think people should have their choice to choose.
Carl, at the moment, the mandate is just for public schools, but private schools are being encouraged to do the same.
Very good, is it? Complicated. Jess Millwood is in Brisbane for us this morning. Jess, Queenslanders could potentially soon ditch their masks.
Restrictions are now under review here in Queensland, Carl, so we could no longer need to wear our masks indoors and no longer need to show proof of our vaccination to gain entry to venues and businesses across the state. Our chief health officer says that we've reached the peak of the Omicron wave, and in fact, we're coming towards the end of it with hospitalisation rates dropping. Spoken to some early risers around Southbank this morning and their opinions on this, well, they are mixed.
I don't think we should have masks, and I don't think that the vaccine should be mandatory at this point.
I would be really pleased to get rid of masks, but I want people to keep checking in. If we've been vaccinated, we want everybody else to be vaccinated too.
A decision will be made by the end of the month. Carl?
Thank you, Jess. Gabrielle Boyle now joins us from Western Sydney. Gabby, QR codes, what's their future?
Who knows, Carl? We know for certain, though, that they're annoying and tedious. Everywhere you go, you have to pull out your phone and check in. It's all designed to make sure that if there's a COVID case in a location that you're visiting, that authorities are able to reach out and contact you and let you know. But, of course, contact tracing is now a thing of the past, and that means health authorities think that QR codes are no longer necessary. They're calling for them to be scrapped at pubs, clubs, restaurants and cafes. Here on the streets of Parramatta, opinion divided about whether we still need QR codes.
Yeah, I think so. Like no one does that anymore.
I think that should still be in just for that, for the safety of the general public and everything. I still QR code in everywhere I go.
Carl, masks and density limits will also be up for debate at the end of the month.
Gabby, thank you.
In breaking news out of Victoria, the Health Minister has just confirmed Category 2 elective surgeries across private and public hospitals in Melbourne will resume from February 21. Pictures just in of billionaire Clive Palmer leaving his super yacht in Sydney. It's the third day in his defamation trial against WA Premier Mark McGowan. Palmer is expected to testify today, with his evidence expected to take 2 days. Also breaking at 8, US President Joe Biden has just spoken, saying a Russian attack on Ukraine remains very much a possibility. It comes despite President Vladimir Putin saying he does not want war and plans to partially withdraw troops from the border.
If Russia does invade in the days and weeks ahead, the human cost for Ukraine will be immense. And the strategic cost for Russia will also be immense. If Russia attacks Ukraine, it'll be met with overwhelming international condemnation.
And we are directly feeling the tensions here at home with petrol prices skyrocketing.
The cost of your mortgage could soon be more expensive, with the Commbank predicting interest rate rises sooner rather than the RBA. Let's bring in Today Money expert Evie Zahos. Evie, good morning to you. What do you think?
Depends on inflation numbers that come out. We'll see those in April. But the biggest bank, as you said, they've moved their forecasts. June is what they're saying. So they're expecting 0.15% increase in the cash rate. By the end of the year, they're saying that cash rate will go up three more times, so 1% in total, because they believe the RBA hasn't got the predictions with the inflation right. So it's those numbers that we're waiting for.
And so where do you sit on this? Who do you think's sort of right on this one? Is it the RBA or the Commbank? And I think the other sort of majors are sort of leaning towards what the Commbank's saying too, aren't they?
Look, whether the RBA is going to be pressured into moving because the big banks are saying, that's another story. But I do believe those inflation numbers that are going to come out are going to blow us out of the water. We know it. We feel it. We're, you know, petrol, food, it's all happening.
Didn't the federal government give the banks a rail run in terms of getting cheaper money?
Well, that's being pulled now. Okay. And there's a concern here that if the job numbers come out, which is tomorrow, they're probably going to be flat. The hours worked a bit less because of Omicron. If you get unemployment right down to that 3%, then more people are in the workforce. There's fear that could put inflationary pressure on further. Are we as bad as the US? No, our inflation numbers aren't that high. So the RBA is kind of saying, hey, we've got time, let's pause. It is important that we see these inflation numbers. I do believe they're going to happen this year, but let's get back to what this story is about. Rates are going to go up this year. So whether we argue it's June, July, August, it's beside the point.
We much prefer the RBA's take, though.
A couple more months.
We're going to listen to them.
Long may they reign.
We do kind of bring some anxiety. Let's remember, most people are ahead in their mortgages. So when rates go up, you probably won't get a tap by your bank saying, hey, repayments must go up, because you're already ahead. So there's some relief.
Good to see you, Effie. Let's get some sport.
Tim, chocolate, yum.
Yeah, we're ready. I know, Alex, I do hope you're enjoying your behind-the-scenes look here at the icon that is Cadbury this morning. We're at the Cadbury factory at Claremont in Hobart, Tasmania, and giving you a bit of a behind-the-scenes of exactly how it goes from the cow. Literally, we have seen the cows this morning, the milk, and into the moulds, the cook-up process, all of that, and then the packaging and how it gets to your store, and, of course, into your mouth, the most important part. It is delicious. More on that in just a moment. But right now, a check of our capital city forecast across Australia on this Wednesday morning for you. A shower at 2:32 for Cairns, Brisbane, a possible shower. Sydney, partly cloudy and 28 degrees. Canberra, mostly sunny for you and 30. Melbourne, a possible late shower, 27 degrees, 25 for both Hobart, where we are. Adelaide as well. Perth, very hot and sunny, 38 degrees, 38 for the Alice. And Darwin, a shower or two, a possible storm, and 34 degrees. Well, over the last 100 years, there have been a lot of leaps forward in terms of technology and the process of how this chocolate is made. But some things stay the same. 48 dairy farms here in Tasmania and 15,000 cows producing that milk. Hobart, of course, was kind of chosen for the climate and the high-quality fresh milk. But 100 years, it is a huge achievement. Penny Wiltshire still joins me here in our little factory tour. Pen, how are you guys celebrating this major milestone?
So it's a huge milestone. What we're doing is we're actually celebrating in store with different centenary wraps. So we're really commemorating through the decades how Cadbury's supported and been with the Australian people. So there's 10 blocks that you could collect. My favourites are probably when we supported the Aussie troops in the World War II. So that's one of the good ones. And of course, how could we forget the Sydney Olympics?
Oh, exactly, the year 2000. I know everyone seems to have a memory and have a story. Watching the process here unfold this morning, though, Carl, has been absolutely awesome. It isn't open to the public anymore, so that makes it extra special to be able to bring it to you right here on the Today Show. We're going to meet some more of the team behind the scenes here coming up in half an hour. We'll see you soon.
It is our favourite chocolate. Thank you, Timmy. Great access today.